two of the top cameras currently on the market. The brand new Fuji XT3 has some legitimate video features with a decent sized APS-C sensor. But wait a second there, little guy, the A7 III is a legitimate full frame camera with low light destroying capabilities and doesn't cost that much more. Which one is the best for making online content? Let's find out. What's up everyone, I'm the Everyday Dad, and if I can figure it out, you can figure it out. This is the video I've been waiting to make since I originally got interested in the Fuji XT3, because I think I'm gonna shock some people. I can't wait. This will be our last video in our week of Fuji XT3 coverage. On Monday, we found out that this camera is a serious contender in the online video sphere. And on Wednesday, we discovered that it can stand confidently toe-to-toe against one of the current kings of video, the Panasonic GH5. And if you wanna get any of these cameras that we've talked about, there will be links in the description below. Now, if you've watched my channel at any point in the last few months or so, you know I'm a huge fan of the Sony A7 III. Since its release, I've been singing its praises as one of my favorite cameras of all time. It's got great autofocus, awesome image quality, and for what you get, the camera is incredibly reasonably priced. Fuji, on the other hand, said, hold my beer, and released what I consider to be a very, very tough challenger to the A7 III. It also has awesome autofocus, serious image quality, costs less than the A7 III, but does so much more when it comes to video. But before we dig too far into the comparisons, let's cover the basic specs of both cameras to get us all on the same page. And I've recently started including disclaimers in my videos because people get hated about cameras. So I'm not a photographer, nor am I a professional videographer. I make home videos and I make these YouTube videos you see. So I'll be covering the specs that matter to the online content creator. The XT3 is an APS-C censored camera from old school cool camera maker Fuji. It has a 26 megapixel BSI X-Trans sensor, 425 point hybrid autofocus system, and it can do improved autofocus face and eye detection. It can do 10 bit 420H265 internal video capture, and that's 422 over HDMI, with 4K 60 frames per second up to 400 megabits a second. And it has dual UHS 2 SD card slots, which tops the A7 III. And the USB-C connector can be used to charge the camera while in use. The A7 III, on the other hand, is a full frame camera from old school consumer electronics manufacturer Sony. It has a 24 megapixel full frame backside illuminated CMOS sensor. It has 693 phase detection autofocus points. It can do 4K up to 30 frames per second. It has in-body image stabilization. It has the larger Z-type battery, which is one of the best features, by the way. It also has dual SD card memory slots, but only one is the Type 2, and it also has a USB-C that will allow you to charge it while using it. Physically, both cameras feel more similar than they do different. It's not as big of a difference as there was between the Fuji and the Panasonic GH5, they both feel pretty darn good. Now for me personally, the A7 III does feel a little bit bigger in the hand because it's big enough that my entire hand can comfortably hold it without needing an extra grip. The XT3 is a little smaller, and that means a couple of my fingers won't have a place to rest when doing handheld run and gun video. The A7 III has plenty of buttons and dials that allow you to change basically every function you could want from the camera body itself, which is a pretty big benefit in my book. You also get a range of customizable function buttons on the button that lets you really make the camera your own. However, the XT3 takes this up to 11, with not only all sorts of buttons, but also two dials that allow you to physically change the shutter speed and the ISO, and I am really, really starting to like those two buttons. I wish more cameras had them. But let's compare these two gargantuan video cameras against each other in the three most important aspects of cameras to me. Think of it as a smaller
pillars of action.
First up, image quad. You know what? No, we're doing this my way. First up, fiddliness. Boom! It's my video, I can put fiddliness first. Like I said, I create online videos, and with some of these online compression systems, technical image quality is not the most important spec. Okay, are we done booing? It's not that important to me or to many creators. What is really important is ease of workflow. Fiddliness is a measure in how much darn fiddling with the camera do I have to do to get the image that I want straight out of it. Ain't nobody got time for color grading. Well, some people do. I don't. I ain't got no time for color grading. And both of these cameras have the same fiddling problem, no flip screen. Not only no flip screen, but their touch functionality only works for focusing, which, while useful if you are behind the camera, it does almost nothing for those of us that spend all of our time in front of the camera. But besides that, both are pretty easy to use and pretty easy to get good image quality out of once you get the hang of them. They both have fantastic autofocus, which, you know, in all fairness, is a pretty big part of winning the battle for the fiddle. Both have plenty of buttons and dials, and both can be customized to work for you. I will say though that the X-T3 wins the fiddliness category for a few reasons. One, it's smaller and the lenses are smaller, making it much easier to carry around. Look, I'm getting old. I need lighter gear to carry around before my old man back gives out. Secondly, and thanks to everyone for pointing this out to me, the X-T3 has this really useful tally light in the front that when enabled will show you if you are recording or not. One of my frustrations with non-flip screen cameras is you have no idea if you're actually recording when you're in front of it. I've ruined whole videos because I thought I was recording, but in the end I was just, you know, talking to myself, which I guess I do a lot, actually. And the third reason, which if you saw Monday's video, this is not gonna come as a surprise, is actually one of my favorite things about the X-T3. The accessory port door is an all-in-one package that gets out of the way, but two, it comes off. Seriously, the thing I hate most about the A7iii are the accessory port doors. Look at these things. These always get in the way and take way more time to set up when you're using monitors, microphones, or external power. That is the definition of fiddliness. And we don't like fiddliness, so this, I know it's a weird thing to complain about, but I hate this. Okay, second comparison, we'll go over image qual, no we won't, we'll go over ecosystem. Boom, I'm subverting all sorts of expectations today. Camera ecosystem is a pretty big deal. This camera body by itself does nothing but waste money. To actually get an image out of it, you need at least a battery, lens, and an SD card. But if you want really good quality, there are additional battery grips, audio adapters, etc. that make the experience better and the images more vibrant. That was a good one. Now both cameras have an amazing selection of lenses. The Fuji X mount has darn near every lens you could hope for, and the Sony E mount has some of the most cutting edge optical technology built in, and they're always releasing more. While I do think Fuji has an awesome range of accessories, including a nice battery grip that will apparently be sold out forever, I don't ever think it's coming in stock again, kind of like the A7iii. I'm gonna give the ecosystem award to the A7 for a couple of reasons. One, the A7iii can use both full frame and E-mount APS-C lenses. That greatly increases the versatility of the camera, allowing you not only to use more lenses, but you can get a further reach out of your full frame one by cropping in on the sensor. And I use that feature all of the darn time. All of the time, and it's so easy to set up too. Second, and we touched on this back in the GH5 comparison, the A7iii also has a really nice XLR audio adapter that will allow you to get pro level audio from a small little piece of tech that goes straight into the hot shoe. I cannot overstate the importance of little additions like that. They really make or break a camera. And finally, image quality. Wait, no, actually image quality this time. Okay, this one is going to be divisive, but in all seriousness, both have excellent image quality. One of the main things about cameras these days is there really isn't a bad choice. Even older cameras are wonderful, and we've seen on this channel here, even 4 and 5 year old cameras are still kicking butt for those of us making online video. That being said, this one will be a personal preference to each individual. Do you really like how full frame video looks? Well then the X-T3 isn't gonna do that for you. Do you want 4K 60 frames per second? Well then the A7iii isn't gonna be able to do that for you. But personally for me, I think the X-T3 is the better video camera image quality wise. It has so many high end video features that almost nothing on the market, you know, barring the GH5 and GH5S, can touch for the price. I mean, it's legitimately amazing. 4K 60 frames per second, it can do 10 bits straight in the camera. The Eterna profile looks awesome and the preamps are great. I really, really like the X-T3. It doesn't have in-body stabilization where the A7iii does, but I've never really been impressed with the A7iii's stabilization. So what, right? So which of these cameras is better for online content creation? This video puts me in a tough place. The A7iii is a camera that I've loved using since its release. For the price, it is a fantastic camera that in my mind is still king of the full frame realm. It has Sony's new color science that in my mind fixes a lot of problems with older Sony bodies. You know, the Sony A6300 making me look like I'd been punched in the face. The autofocus is legitimate. and I've never had an issue overheating. It is just a real solid workhorse of a camera. But the X-T3, for the price and features, I think it is one of the, if not the best cameras out there for quick online turnaround. When I first heard about it, I didn't think too much about it because I've never used a Fuji camera before. And it wasn't too high on my priority to check out. But in my week of using it, I am caught almost speechless with how good it is. The eye autofocus, the recording modes, the tally light. I mean, everything about this camera is, it's fantastic. I mean, there's no real other way to say it. It's not hyperbole. This is a fantastic camera. And if you're looking for a quick turnaround online content camera, you should 100% at least consider and look into the Fuji X-T3. It's darn good. Thanks for watching.